welcome to this Thanksgiving week edition of Big Game Bound. I'm Chris Hagan. Turkey Day means feasting on food and football, so we'll keep this one brief. The day starts at 12:30 Eastern with the traditional game in Detroit. The 4-6 Packers taking aim at the division-leading Lions, now 8-2 on the season, and in the mix for the top seed in the NFC.
We've got a great task in front of us, a team that's really gotten after us the last, I don't know how many times we played them, four times or whatever it is. Got a lot of respect for Dan and what he's been able to establish here, the culture. And they got a good thing going right now. So it's going to be, we're going to need our best effort, no doubt about it, to go into their building and come out on top.
Dallas also hosting its annual Thanksgiving Day game, 4:30 Eastern against the Commanders. Washington 4-7 on the season, with head coach Ron Rivera sitting firmly on the hot seat.
I can only control what I can. And as long as things that we want to be going in the right direction seem to be doing that, that's a positive. What happens from beyond today, what happens from beyond the end of the season, that's not in my control. So everything I'm going to do is just focusing on today. I mean, the now and present. That's the only thing I have.
Out in Seattle, a big one in the NFC West, the division-leading 49ers taking on the Seahawks. San Fran with just a one-game lead in those standings.
You go up to Seattle, it's as hard as it gets. And it's one of the toughest places to play in the NFL, if not the toughest. They have a certain style there that, and the way they play, that is harder to deal with on the road because of how loud it is and the snap count disadvantage. So it's always tough to go there. And I also know, just starting with them today, how many good players they have, how well they're coached, and how big of a challenge it'll be this Thursday.
A new wrinkle to the NFL holiday schedule this year, a first-ever Black Friday game. The Dolphins visiting the Jets, and a change of quarterback for New York. Tim Boyle is in. Zach Wilson is out.
Zach's fine. He's come a long way from a year ago, and, I think we all agree we wish it was better. Obviously, we wish it was better for him. We wish we all could have been better for him. And again, it's like I've said, it's not a one-person thing, but just to see if we can get something going.
What do you think of being part of a first-of-its-kind sort of game, Black Friday?
Definitely excited about it. But obviously, we're going to miss, Thanksgiving with our family. Like I say, any chance we get to play this beautiful game of football, I'm honored, blessed, grateful, all that.
On the Sunday slate, the Saints trying to move above the 500 mark at Atlanta. The Steelers visit a Bengals team that will be without Joe Burrow, the star QB, out for the season. The 1-9 Panthers in Nashville to face the Titans. The Buccaneers in Indianapolis to take on a 5-5 Colts team that's coming off its bye. The struggling Patriots on the road against the Giants. And a big one in the AFC South as the first place Jaguars invade Houston to take on the second place Texans. Four games in the 4 o'clock window. The 7-3 Browns looking to keep it rolling in Denver. The Broncos, however, winners of four straight. The Rams and Cardinals square off in Arizona. A short week for the Chiefs as they look to bounce back in Vegas against the Raiders. And the Bills in Philly against the now 9-1 Eagles. In the Sunday night game, the 8-3 Ravens facing the Chargers. This one, an almost must win for LA. They're just 4-6 on the season. And on Monday Night Football, the Bears in Minnesota, the Vikings hoping to start a new winning streak after their five-game run was snapped last week out in Denver. Now it's time for Peyton's Picks, provided by our guy in Chi-Town, Jared Peyton, the son of sweetness, 1-2 last week, but still looking good, 20-13 on the season for the Thanksgiving games. JP likes the Lions over the Packers, the Cowboys over the Commanders, and he'll take the 49ers on the road against the Seahawks. All favorites. We'll see if the chalk comes through. Hey, that will do it for us on this Thanksgiving edition of the show. For producer Phil Nardiello and all of our correspondents across the NextStar Nation, I'm Chris Hagan. Eat well, enjoy the football, and we'll see you next time on Big Game Bound.